To Bruce if you met him?
Shorten your concerts.
Destroy themselves, yet have no urge to commit suicide. They experience the vilest of garish, frightening hallucinations. They suffer extreme nausea, severe vomiting, aches and pains, anxiety, panic, depression.
Sounds like it's going to be a big problem.
If it isn't, it'll do till one comes along. If it isn't, it'll do till one comes along. If it isn't, it'll do till one comes along. Joe, Bill, the real issue here is the degree of danger this drug presents to the psychological health of the user, along with the resultant effect of the user and those around him.
And as of now, there's no law covering the sale and use of LSD.
From the number of cases coming through this lab, I'd say they better give you people something to work with damn soon.
Even in a dilapidated, vacant park connected to the lake, which at this point might as well almost be ruins, there's still a peacefulness that seems on any sort of dock area that is adjacent to a body of water. This was, I believe, the largest, at least at the time, I think the largest man-made lake ever.
This is so cool, Melissa. What? You look so funny.
Let me see.
Wait, Jason, you look really goofy and weird. That looks really funny.
That's rather harsh.
Can I look now, Brendan? Oh my gosh, is this so awesome?
We could make so many cool movies with that thing.
Brendan, you look like a creepy, freaky kid.
Ooh. Stop. How do you feel, Rosemary?
Melissa, can I look now, please?
Sure, Jason.
What's the big deal?
The image is all distorted, isn't it?
Doesn't everything look weird, Jason?
Yeah.
So isn't that funny?
Good?
Brendan, I wouldn't buy this.
Huh?
The fisheye lens is kind of a tired device.
No.
Is it really worth it? It's rather hackneyed.
You can put my name on this bad boy, my good man, because I'll be back to buy it very, very soon.
Well, we close in an hour.
Oh, no, I mean soon, like in a few days soon, or, you know, weeks or something like that. Soon, not now.
And there is also, I believe it's from when they were making it, a place called Andersonville, which was essentially, I guess, you know, buried in the process of making the lake. Every once in a while you see something about it in the paper. I think that may be the area where some gargantuan catfish have been reported. Whether this is urban legend or not of this area, I am not sure. But I've heard the story more than once that people went diving down there to do whatever it is that they were going to do, and that the size of the catfish was so large that they just left and didn't go back. I think I can think of a couple of things that a couple shows back when the camera cut off. That I was trying to get to when I mentioned face and the face that you. It's like the face you want to have when you're looking in a mirror to go out and present to people. And then when you see yourself on something like this, or pictures, or even, you know, just a reflection of the glass or something like that, I always get the feeling that I failed miserably. But it's really just that you're you know, everyday moment-to-moment expression is not, or however yours is, when you're trying to get things perfect in the mirror. And I'm not sure what the other one was right now. I am listless today, as I had faith that since I had so many opportunities to gather content, being that this is Monday and yesterday I was already working on some of the fun video things that I do at the beginning. I guess that's a potential advantage over a live podcast, is although I keep it pretty real, you do have the option of a lot more have the opportunity for a lot more polishing. And I immediately started having fun with and utilizing the capacity for a B-roll or overlay or some combination thereof. I had a wonderful time at something called the South Carolina Upstate Pagan Pride Day this past Saturday. Just being outside with familiar spirits and beautiful weather and having somewhat common mind on at least a sliver of those things which we hold sacred in those areas which would border on the religious and ceremonial. I got a black mirror, which is for an activity called skying, that you can either use a black mirror for, or a black bowl, preferably, I believe, one that would not be plastic. And in the case of the black bowl, you fill it about maybe halfway with water, but with what you do is one of those very simple things that are available to everybody. So let me get to the Old Testament and witchcraft in a second. But it's an activity or I guess it would also be considered a divination available to everyone. And the first part of not just this, but many activities that I've been involved with in the craft have to do with energy, harnessing it, releasing it, trying to guide it to positive purposes. And in this particular method, or I should say one of the ways of doing that, is by simply rubbing your hands together until you start feeling a little bit of heat. And then you release them a little bit, and you You feel that ball of energy. And the common first thing to do is when we don't harness it like that. But I like to do this because I can still feel that it's like a magical, it's not like, it's a magical, well, it's a magical ball, but so much of what society has deemed supernatural or magical is painted that way, probably more often than not out of ignorance, but the larger reason for it is that those who would shape society to their own ends do not want the average consumer worker to realize just how much control an individual has and how much potential and, you know, if you're not careful, you can let yourself be robbed of your own sovereignty and free will. Okay, what I need to really fix up this energy, so I will lift my hands and let it be taken where it needs to, other than drop them to the earth and finish them in my belly area, just below the belly button, so that we, hopefully what needed to go there, right there, and then also one is welcome to keep some of the energy for themselves, and that is the what goes on in the final part of placing your hands on yourself. That's funny how there's that, I guess maybe it would be a colloquialism about not talking about politics and religion. It's probably because, the circus of the alleged joke is that what all you'll do is argue and you know, you'll have a good time and that type of thing. But I believe the larger point there is that, again, certain elements of society would have us operate as weebles or Fisher-Price men. They don't want you really questioning things too much. And that's where, as I see it, religion has gone pretty much astray from the beginning. For example, killing in God's name, as if not some of the wars, all of the wars, if the truth be known, had something to do with that, or at least were based on that false conflict. Which is what some years ago, I believe they went to calling most wars in history books. We started calling them conflicts instead of wars. And even though the New World Order has been written about and spoken about and admitted for years and years in both word and deed and document, at the same time been promoted heavily as a conspiracy theory, which is what I find aspects of society often do, is they they play both sides of an issue because the issues are almost always more about either hysteria or playing with your heartstrings or getting people angry or getting people outraged over something that they have virtually no facts about, which usually never happened in the first place. Because I believe that if people figured out what churches are really about on an upper level, like one group of people that I know of, that perhaps some seniors are part of the 501c program, which signs you up with the government. Neither a borrower nor a lender be. You can't serve two masters. You gotta serve somebody. There's a mutually exclusive principle. And being about freedom and free will and creativity and learning and spirituality and being grounded and connecting yourself in the proper way to others and to living things and having that reverence. There is a fundamental principle problem with espousing that on one hand and then signing on to the government's bullshit, which of course always has carrots. I'm sure there's some sort of tax incentive or on some level money being received. And I don't have any negative feelings towards the people themselves who I am thinking of. But I do have the right of free speech, and as far as the organizational structure of anything like that, including churches, which people believe the preacher is looking out for them and has their best interest at heart. But yet, most of the mainline churches are also 501c. And they receive money from the government. They are in collusion with Homeland Security and other agencies. Public information, you can look it up. Don't believe them. The state being God is something that's been thrust more and more upon us. Whether these stories happen or not, I doubt, but they wanted us to believe that there was a Bible study broken up in one of the Midwestern or Western states, I believe, a month and a half or so ago. I also heard that Christianity is no longer being encouraged or considered the predominant the religion of America anymore. That was said in some official or semi-official capacity. And obviously, I don't think governments should be, since they are, I don't think they should be aligned with any particular religion, which has never been the case. It's just that they've been serving one religion while paying lip service to another. Understanding the mistaken belief was that the government was Christian, which implied to the uninitiated wholesomeness and goodness and fairness and fucking apple pie. But without getting into the too much of the details of that, the point of what I was trying to say is that these things have been, they've been put upon us like a tide that brings a little bit in, you know, the water comes in to a certain point where it keeps dissipating, but there are deposits being left all the time. You know, and they keep hearing different circles talking about the economic collapse as if it's going to be some other big event, which it may be, but the point is the economic collapse has already been well with us, depending on how you look at it. But at least the latest debacle in 2008, which as usual, one president is in lockstep with the next president on, despite whatever differences they try to make people believe they have the campaign. Whenever both sides are always funded by the same banks, or at least have been for the last decade or so. I mean, that's not rocket science either. It's just, you know, but I don't mean to get political. I guess I've said that before. Except to the point of trying to point out the lunacy of it, which I have come to understand on a greater level now that I see that there are so many actors that are politicians. Whether you want to talk about some of the faces on World War I from Nazi Germany, who were clearly actors in Hollywood at that time, or another one of the easiest examples is to look at the Green Party and the actors that are participating in that. And we've talked about this in some of our discussions with some of you. I didn't mean, that time when I said we exposed so-and-so, I simply meant that I made, you know, one of the videos that showed that Mitt Romney is after Richard Jenkins. So if I was misunderstood there to be perceived as being on the same level as someone with this exposure, that was not my intention, that's not what I meant. Okay. So the point I was trying to make about Christianity and communism and socialism has been very slowly thrust upon us. And, I mean, it was already happening when there were things like alcohol, tobacco, and firearms, urban development, EPA, FDA, etc. And these things were set up and sold to the people on one basis and premise, which they too have some degrees fulfilled, usually poorly. But like a claw on one of those rip-off machines that comes in and scoops things up, only in this case, rather than the scoop dropping those things, that scoop is has taken and is taking what many of us believe to be the American life away. When I say that, I am thinking of things like NAFTA and GATT, which again were sold to the people as a positive thing.
If we don't take this deal, you can bet that Japan will try to take this deal. They'll be in there in a New York minute. Europe will try to get this deal. They are concerned about us taking this deal. Listen, we ought to thank our
Honda deal. Is there anything about it?
Here it is, folks. As they say, it's in the book. There's the Honda deal. Here is the Tennessee whiskey deal.
Is there anything about the deal you don't like?
Stay with me 1 second. Here is the deal on Tennessee whiskey. Only in the state of Tennessee. Authorized to produce only... in the state of Tennessee. No. This is foreign lobbying big time. This is what's wrong with our country. This is what you and I will clear up through government reform.
That's protection of a brand name.
This is foreign lobbying big time. This is what's wrong with our country. This is what you and I will clear up through government reform.
That's protection of a brand name.
This is foreign lobbying big time. This is what's wrong with our country. This is what you and I will clear up through government reform.
That's protection of a brand name. That's protection of a brand name. One of the things about this treaty is it protects intellectual property.
Why just that brand name?
Well, it's not just that brand name. If you look at the line above it, it says bourbon whiskey.
Century of manufacturing jobs in the millions, factories. Part of which the fake Ross Brough character was referring to back in the election of 92. And see, there again, even when there are people on the stage, whether it be a presidential debate or whatever kind of stage it might be, the opposition is almost never the opposition. Another example of that is, I believe, that Greenpeace started off as a genuine an organization that was for the environment and, try to keep the government's reach off of many things that do need to be preserved. I believe it has now been pretty much all the way taken over by people who do not have that interest as part of their agenda, just like the revolving door between the EPA and FDA and Goldman Sachs and Munson on the Supreme Court. And, you know, what do I mean by that claw having us now in its grip? I would refer you once again to the pediatric cancer rates. I believe when I said nerve-related disorders, I meant to say neurological the other week. As is also related to chemtrails, which, as I said, have now been admitted by the establishment. But I mean, I can still see why people would tend to want to turn away from these subjects. I certainly have my ways of escaping, I guess, and shutting it out at times. I hope I've been able to get a scoop of it into eyes and ears that might not otherwise have heard it. Obviously, needless to say, I'm no expert in whether you doubt anything I say or not. Please do your own research and look things up. One of the baffling things about corporate interests being opposed to the best thing for the people is that so many of us are part of those corporations to some degree or another, and that alone would cause one to, I guess, perhaps look at things with less of other magnifying glass. I was certainly not expected to end up here as often as I have, but I'm glad I started doing it. I believe the main leaf changing in this area has passed now. The other thing I meant to say when I was talking about the Black Mirror is that if you saw the video I made about PPD, you can find it on click through my Vimeo channel. As I said, I don't have things well organized there, but if you just keep scrolling down to the next pages, you'll find anything I've put there. And let's see, why did I mention that? Oh, because it shows the Black Mirror. The one shot is kind of dull, but the other one with the Black Mirror, which I'm not sure if that's the same one I bought or not, but it shows the reflection of the trees in the sky above. Wu-Tang. 1995! Okay, well, that's probably good for this session. I'm not sure if I'll be adding to this. Probably will be. Beethoven. Don't love.